So in a previous video, which I'll post up above, I had a little art haul with Royal Talens products that I got on sale because they're having a worldwide sale, and I bought these through Currys, which is a Canadian art supply company. And I've been wanting to try, oil paint for a very, very long time. It's something I've never really used. And I've been reading articles about Anders Zorn's oil palette that he used, or that he used quite a bit. It's a very restrictive palette, and it involves just four colors, and one of them is yellow ochre and ivory black and vermilion or cadmium red light and white, titanium white. So I was a little concerned with starting to work on oils that my studio's not set up for good exhaust for, you know, different mediums and spirits and everything, especially in the wintertime. In the summertime, I could open windows, and I have windows on both sides of the studio, but in the wintertime is a little bit different. And, you know, cleanup, I kind of wanted easier, so I did buy these Royal Talens Cobra line of oil paints because they're water mixable. Cleanup is supposed to be easy with them, so we'll see if that's all true. And they have their own mediums to use with them. You can use other watercolor paints or other oil paints with them, but obviously not in the same way. And yeah, so Jackson's Art Supply, which I've bought from before, had a blog that the day after I had this delivery, they had a blog about the Zorn palette, and they've set up different color charts for mixing these four colors together. So I'm going to do one of them. It's the one where black is added to yellow ochre and vermilion, and down this side is the amount of white that is used. And I'm using Arches oil paper for this chart. And I'll also put a link to that Jackson's blog just below in the comments, so you can see for yourself the various charts that the artist did just using these four colors. So I'm not going to talk too much during this video. It's just going to be mixing and, whoop, that's kind of different how that comes out. Mixing the colors. Not really sure how much to put out. And maybe set to some music. And then we'll get going. And I certainly have a lot of white, so that's not going to be an issue, except when I get it all over me. Okay. And for this, I'm just going to use a palette knife, because it's a little bit easier mixing. So I'm actually going to be looking at the chart while I'm doing it. So they start off with a little bit of black. Let's try that. And yellow. And then white, 95% white.